This video is rated WH for Wookiee horniness. Viewer discretion is advised. Welcome to the channel, ladies and gentlemen. Boss the Hunter here, and today we're doing something a little bit different. Now listen, I'm a huge Star Wars fan, a massive Star Wars fan, and over the years I've consumed more Star Wars media through books, comics, television shows, whatever I could get my hands on. But I realized there's an entire trilogy of Star Wars movies that I have never seen, a forgotten trilogy, if you will. Now, what am I talking about? I'm talking about the made-for-TV movies, the Star Wars Holiday Special, Caravan of Courage, and the Battle for Endor. Now, I purposely have never seen these movies because I've heard they're horrendously bad, and the stories that you hear of them are laughable. But today, we're changing that. This is going to be the first of three videos, the Forgotten Star Wars Trilogy, starting with the Holiday Special. It's going to be a little bit of different of a video. I'm going to be having a drink, relax. There's going to be some cussing in this video, just make you guys aware. We're going to sit back, chill. We're going to talk about the Holiday Special as we watch it together. For me, watching it for the very first time, getting my off-the-cuff reactions. If you're a fan of my retrospectives, know that I am working on Jedi Academy as we speak. That video should be out soon. It just takes a lot of time to do those retrospectives, but I am working on one. We're doing a Jedi game, the first Jedi game we're going to do, so I figured why not start with arguably the best. But thanks for being here, guys. Let's sit back, let's watch some Holiday Special, and get into it.
We don't need that scum.
All the New Hope clips. All of them. No new CGI. It's gonna be good. I can tell. I got a good feeling. It's so crazy that they actually have all the... This is the only thing with all the original cast. Until the new movies or the sequels.
His father,
the thing is fucking horrifying looking.
His son, Lumpy. With special guest star, Beatrice Arbor.
I was not expecting a golden girl in this thing. It's just a hand-drawn, it's like a Bob Ross painting. That's the background. Some pretty trees. You put some pretty, pretty little trees back here. In our 1970s looking house. Got the shag carpet going on. Hell yeah. I guess that's supposed to be like grass. I mean, at least we got some good Wookiee sound effects, I guess. Get the fuck over here. Chewbacca's kids are a little hellion, clearly. His lack of a father being in the home caused a lot of issues. Yeah, no discipline. It's sad, really. I can definitely watch a Wookiee take the trash out of him. This is a George Lucas-made Star Wars. This was filmed on George Lucas's back patio. Chewbacca's son's first suicide attempt. Can't get the Bob Ross painted background. I like it. Makes me think of those pictures of Ewan McGregor that old folks think are Jesus and they put up in their house. What the fuck is wrong with his mouth? Is he like supposed to be toothless? But he has teeth. Well, he has one tooth, I say. Oh, God, that's even awful. Oh, God. You got the whole galaxy of entertainment. This is what you fucking watch. It's like a drag show. Stop trying to trance the kids, George Lucas. Good lord. Infecting this Wookiee juvenile. Good thing you're not in Florida. I'll tell you that much. Thank you. Turn this shit off. Oh, no. You made it three times bigger. It's like a mix of, like, Kiss and a drag show. In Star Wars. Those are not three things I want to see combined. Let's take Kiss and then drag queens in Star Wars.
It's Chewbacca's family.
He's like, oh god damn, not these people again. Shit. R2, I told you to turn this shit off. Sure you guys weren't trying to reach Han? I can give you his number.
Oh, wait a minute, I don't like the looks of this. Let me get this fixed.
His dry ice machine is breaking. Holy shit. You know this guy? You could just use his name just to show his picture. He speaks their language. He doesn't need to see a picture of the guy.
Listen, I wouldn't worry about
about Chewbacca. Like, Luke doesn't want to tell him. Like, look, I don't think Chewbacca wants to come see you guys. I don't want to be the one to tell you this, but your house seems terrible. He'll make it. I'm sorry.
Chewie's not going to want to come home to a house full of long faces, is he?
Thank you. Or at all. Oh, God. What is going on here? Oh, my God. R2 just purposely did that. R2 trying to kill Luke.
So do I, as a matter of fact. I take a drink once in a while. But... I just thought I'd show you some of the stupid stuff.
I hate fish. Me too, but I do like alcohol.
She did it all by herself. In fact, you might say she did it by hand. Solo.
Just a groomer.
Called him a groomer. Jesus just Christ. Would you call me? Sir, I have never. He helped produce that weird drag juggling show we saw earlier. Why have we not had the insane old merchant return as a canon character, Disney? Oh, great. Back to the Wookiee house. I'm sure we'll see what menial chore they're up to. Oh, they're still washing dishes. What'd I call? I called that. I think we're in a vacuum. It's going to be great. Dust. Get a little dusting in. I bet the place is dusty. They are hairy. Yeah. The hell? He just smacking her? Oh, he just said, fuck you, I'm done doing dishes. That kid's definitely ended up in an Imperial penal camp. 100%.
Hello.
Today we just say hello, but make Wookiee say. Oh, I'm sorry, the next menial task we're going to do is cooking. You're going to watch Wookiees cook. I mean, why watch Rebels try to overthrow a Galactic Empire when we can watch Wookiees cook Bantha one? I don't know why I asked stupid questions like that. It's a step-by-step cooking video. Now we know how to cook Bantha one, guys. Why does she have a necklace of spice? You know what? I'm asking a very stupid question considering everything going on. That is the least weird thing here. What am I thinking? Never mind. Spice necklace, good to go. Chewbacca's wife has no rhythm. No rhythm. She must be white underneath all that fur. She is not matching this at all. Look at this. Jesus Christ. Oh, what the? He's got another arm. Is this supposed to be a robot? And if so, why do they have such massive boobs? Someone had to design that and build that and make a mold. Think about that. This is going to taste like shit. I'm going to tell you right now. This is going to be inedible. If they eat this at the end of the movie, I'll be shocked. Picture kills me. Like Chewbacca's high school graduation photo. Did he say the Kazook planet? Where the fuck is that? I thought we were on Kashyyyk. Go get the door, Grandpa. Come on. You toothless old fuck. 19th. This is a Brady Bunch house in Star Wars. So I guess Grandpa's getting some VR. Is this the Wookiee watching porn thing? I've heard about this, actually. Oh my god.
We are excited, aren't
we? He's in the living room, by the way. The whole family's at the house. I cannot believe this is Star Wars. If you just showed me this with no Wookiees, I'd be like, what kind of trippy 70s bullshit was this? You get the whole galaxy to explore, and you're watching some kind of juggling drag show, and now this? There's got to be something better on TV. Go to the History Channel, watch a Clone Wars documentary. Jawa Pawn Stars. That's what I want to watch. Jawa Pawn Stars. I think Jawas would give better deals than Rick. Honest to God. That man ripping people off. I feel like releasing this between the movies could have hurt Empire Strikes Back sales. So people saw this like, where the fuck is this franchise going? No, I'm not going to the second one. In some kind of office. Star Wars and the accounting department of the Rebel Alliance. Gotta crunch these numbers, 3PO. X-Wings aren't gonna buy themselves. Everybody pretending like they want to talk to these people. They're like, God damn it.
She says it may be a happy life day for you.
She just sent a voicemail. She's
seen happy. Would you do me a favor and send either Chewbacca or Han Solo to the screen, please?
I don't like, can you get the fuck off the TV and be talking to somebody actually?
I'm quite unable to do so.
Mala, are you alone?
No, Grandpa's beating off in the living room, but I can talk.
You'll do that for me, won't you?
You get them off the phone for me, won't you, Zondek?
That's what I'm here for.
Yes, ma'am. I know they're annoying as shit. Our Imperial's gonna, like, bust up Life Day. I really hope. Oh, dude! I called the shit out of that! It's like, this house is very clean. I can see you've been doing menial chores all day. Excellent. Garbage taken out? Check. Dishes washed? Check. Bantha loin. Check.
He had a terrible fight with her husband. He just stormed right out of
your identification.
I said
Wookiee domestic violence. Man, they got in a fight. He slapped around a little and he stormed out. We're going to need that to you, sir.
Search the dwelling.
Take a report. Call Child Protective Services. B. Arthur's going to bust up here in a minute and just save the day. Going to beat the shit out of these stormtroopers. Golden Girls thing going to be playing in the background. This guy loves to put guns in people's faces. He's the most aggressive stormtroopers. Oh no, this is the Jefferson Starship, isn't it? This is the most phallic-shaped microphone I've ever seen in my life. Why is his microphone is like a little purple Mace Windu lightsaber? It's like I'm watching like Easy Rider or something right now instead of Star Wars. He's like, wow, that was pretty terrible, wasn't it? There's a Bantha one to wash that shit down with. My phone's going off. Somebody knows I'm watching horrible shit trying to save me. I say, come out. Let's go get a drink. No, I gotta watch crappy Star Wars movies and make videos. It's what I do now. It's my life.
Oh, I almost forgot. I want to leave you my car in case you need any
Straight to the gun in the face again. That stormtrooper is not playing. He is ready to smoke somebody. They should have sent this guy after Luke and Han. They treat him like shit. Look at that. Put the gun in the kid's face. Just bitch slapped a Wookiee to the ground. I mean, dude, this guy's like a Terminator unit. I need this Stormtrooper's TK number because he needs a promotion.
Continue our search.
What the fuck was that? I thought this was supposed to be like a serious moment. Just Grandpa just got the shit slapped out of him by a Stormtrooper.
Oh, it's not be the bullshit cartoon.
I'm excited about this. I'm not gonna lie. I like it. It's got the old like Star Wars comic book, like the old Star Wars comic books look. Ooh, Boba Fett. Yeah, if you look at his design, like the gun and stuff, like clearly where the Mandalorian got a lot of inspiration, which is awesome.
What's wrong?
Chewbacca was high as shit. I'm not gonna comment on what say no looks like. Boba Fett, you son of a bitch.
What is it now?
I'm definitely not watching anti-imperial cartoon propaganda. Quick, switch it to Itchy's porn channel. I am actually enjoying this cartoon. This has easily been the best part of the movie. Hands down. Han Solo looks like Sarah Jessica Parker. Darth Vader's right-hand man. He got a fucking promotion in this. That stormtrooper with his blaster. He's literally like a baseball bat now. That's my favorite stormtrooper of all Star Wars. Whatever this guy's name is. He needs a spinoff. Oh, the suspicious Bantha toy.
Go clean up your room.
Oh, ass. It's like, bro, I'm trying to watch Boba Fett over here. I ain't got time for that shit. Been doing chores all day. He said, the head of my Bantha better not be ripped the fuck off, or that's y'all's asses. I was like, oh, that's y'all's asses. He said, death to the Empire. I guess he's an android? I don't really know what the fuck is going on. Is he grabbing his own ass? It's a Ziploc sandwich bag with some screwdrivers in it. Locate the Ziploc sandwich bag with two screwdrivers. The way he talks reminds me of G-Man from Half-Life. Wake up, Mr. Freeman. Wake up.
Blue goes to blue. And
so dude, that's totally what he sounds like.
Watch me. It is required viewing for all members of the Imperial forces.
Time one guy pointed like, bro, pay attention. Got a cantina scene? I did not know this. The guy keeps like, bro, pay attention. You need to watch your shit. Watch this cantina scene, it's important. Again, this was supposed to be a mandatory Imperial broadcast of all Imperial citizens.
Until tonight, I thought about it.
Why in God's name would the Empire make them watch this?
I'll be waiting.
Oh God, he's fucking creepy as shit.
I decided what you meant was exactly the thing I needed to hear.
Dude, this guy's come off as a straight stalker. Call the stormtroopers, D. He is behind the bar now. He has crossed the line. Yeah, this is why it's mandatory Imperial watching. This guy's a registered Tatooine sex offender. Holy shit, what did I just say? I called it. He's on some watch list, people. That's all I'm saying.
Have another drink. This one's on me.
That's not how you handle a situation, ladies. If you're watching this, you don't know. Do not give people more alcohol They're trying to assault you. Guys, pay attention. Look for these people. That's who you should be after, not these Wookiees. This guy. She's got a bouncer. He's not doing a very good job keeping her safe. She literally got assaulted in her own bar. That bouncer sucks. Torque. Give me a beer. I don't want any more trouble. Torque sucks. It's just a giant rat. It's like a Princess Bride, right? In the wrong set, bud. It's like George Lucas just got drunk with a bunch of his friends at his house with all the costumes left over. He's like, let's make a holiday special, guys. And they're like, what are you talking about, George? Bro, get my camera. Got an idea. And then they watched it and they were like, dude, this is awesome. And they were all so drunk. They're like, George, you need to put this on TV. He's like, I'm George Lucas. I'm the hottest thing right now. I can do whatever I want. Fuck yeah, let's put this on TV. And that's how this happened. The sex offender dude is still there. This is the PSA still? That doesn't even make sense. Does the dude have a long enough antenna on that thing? Good God. I hope this is the stormtrooper who likes to put guns in people's faces. I hope that's the guy he picked to stay. We'll know soon enough because he's going to put his blaster in somebody's face at the first possible opportunity. It's totally him! There you go. What'd I say? Immediately, he's like, blaster in the face. You just get your blaster out and shoot that guy. You don't have to get in a hand-to-hand fight with it. Oh, shit. That shitty Wookiee construction will get you every time. Leaned on it and it broke.
Bye, everybody.
It's like minute cameo. I was here. Bye. George Lucas, make sure my check's in the mail. Oh, shit. Yeah, if we kill a stormtrooper at our house, they're probably going to come looking for him.
Very well, and we'll send out a search party.
Why would you just believe that? Yeah, he went AWOL, stole my shit, and yeah, you should probably go get him. Okay. If this random guy says it, it must be true. Imagine getting to be in Star Wars. And you're like, I'm going to be this cool, like, traitor character. Some Wookiee planet that's not Kashyyyk. And I'll be in Star Wars. I'm like, dude, that'd be awesome. And then you end up, like, you get cast as this. You're like, this will be great. And it's this. It's the holiday special. That's got to be very disappointing. You're going to be like, damn, how did that happen? You got me, George Lucas. Are they going to celebrate life there? Are they going to a clan meeting? What is this? Is that it? Oh, no. Maybe should have been it. It's like the worst holiday ever. I guess they did get gifts. I mean, Grandpa did get his VR porn headset. Oh, they got the celebration music from A New Hope. I love that scene so much. It's one of my favorite scenes in all of Star Wars. I just think it sounds so good. I mean, they go through their medals. That's a great ending. That's such a great ending. I mean, this is terrible. Like, we're getting Chewbacca's graduation photo again. This is a trailer, basically. Like, hey, have you guys seen this movie? This movie's actually good. If you thought this holiday special was shit, check out this. This is quality. Oh, shit, that is it. Mala, Itchy, and Lumpy was the kids. What the fuck could you name your kid Lumpy? Well, that was something. So what do I think about the beginning of our forgotten trilogy, the holiday special? Off the cuff, the Boba Fett cartoon was pretty cool. That was definitely the highlight. I did like that one Imperial kept putting his gun in everybody's face. That was awesome. That guy's cool. I mean, it's just kind of interesting to see the original cast all together for something like this. But Darth Vader never showed up. He just kind of was in videos. But he was voiced by James Earl Jones, so that's awesome. I mean, overall, it's like a 2 out of 10. It really is. It's bad. It's terrible. It's reused assets from A New Hope, along with Wookiees doing chores and watching porn. And then one cool Boba Fett cartoon. So, yeah. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Look forward to the Caravan of Courage and the Battle for Endor. And we're going to complete this trilogy of made-for-TV Star Wars movies. The Forgotten Trilogy. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.